नमस्ते टू ऑल. माई सेल्फ रमेश कुमार, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एसीएम फ्रॉम ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर. ओके, सो टुडे आवर सेशन इज इनलाइन फंक्शन एंड हैविंग सब्जेक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग. Okay, so in last lecture we have studied about the constructor and different types of constructor. Today we will discuss about inline functions. So we will understand what is inline functions. Why inline function? The inline function are similar to the vector. Vector means nothing but objects. With the word defined, the inline functions are similar to the vector. Okay, in the case of the inline function, the function will get replaced by the function definition. It is very important. In the case of inline function, the function call will get replaced by the function definition. That's why the program definition is passed. Again, we come to the macros. Macro means symbolic constants. Nothing but once you declare the value of that remains same, that is the macro. So once the function call is replaced by the function definition, okay, in this case the control remains the same. Actually the reason, the logic behind the function call replaced by the function definition is that the control remains the same. That's why the program definition is passed. The general form is, again I'm telling that the function call is the very important, this is the focus point. The function, in the case of inline function, the function call will get replaced by the function definition. The reason, that's why the control remains the same and the program execution is very fast. The general form is inline, return type, function name and argument name. Okay, the general form is inline, return type, function name and argument name. Okay, and tuple braces open and body of the function, then tuple braces close. So this is the way by which we can declare the inline function. Okay, next slide. So the main advantage in case of the inline function is that the control remains in the name of the body function, so the overall program is faster. In the focus point, in the name, the body function, in the case of inline function is that the control remains in the name of the body function, so the program is faster. Consider the following program has include IOS print object, memory object, query function definition, inline word, a square, int num, that is also open, int real, cout, indel, a square, okay, equal to num, multiply num, that is also close, void main, that is also close. So here what we see, this is the inline function, inline void square int num. So here this is the function definition, and here again the inline functions. So in the main function, the calling function, inline function is that control remains in the main function, so the overall program is used faster. Here the control remains in this here, that's why the control did not move from the air, that's why the program is little faster. Int real, int num real, CARSTR, see out in rain, enter the number, see in num, a square num function call. So here is a square num, this function call, and here the function with no sense. Okay, we then void a square with num. So a square num, the main drawback of the event function, it is the mercy of the compiler whether the function can be considered as an event function or not. The event function cannot contain too many statements. Okay, the event function cannot contain too many statements. Because of that, it cannot contain the conditional statement, it cannot contain. So what you see, this is the major drawback of the event function. It is the, it cannot contain the conditional loop. Okay, the event function cannot contain too many statements. Okay, it is not for bigger statement and too many statements. It is used for a small programs and for single statements or two or more statements. Thank you to all. So this is the today about the event functions, and I think you all understand what is event function, why do you like, why you use event functions. So it is very easy that event function is used for a small program, simple program, and for program functions. I think you all hear the concept. So today this is all about, and I think you like my video. So comment it more and more, subscribe it, suggest it. Okay, thank you for today's videos.